There's currently something very interesting going on with Siacoin mining, because the best miner for Sia is also one of the most affordable. And not only that, but it's also actually profitable. Even at this point in the crypto bear market, as long as you have at least a somewhat decent electric rate. And this is actually pretty strange, because usually we see the exact opposite, where it's the very high-end and very expensive miners that are the most efficient at mining a particular coin. But apparently, not in this case, and as a matter of fact, it just so happens that this Siacoin miner is also the most profitable miner that costs under $500 right now. So, in this video, I want to do three things. First, we'll have a look at the current landscape of Siacoin miners. We're then going to have a look at the current landscape of miners below $500. And finally, I'm going to give you a quick and to the point guide for how to mine Siacoin and what I recommend doing if you want to get into Siacoin mining. And that second part of the video is only made possible thanks to CoinMiningCentral, who sent me this SC Box 2, which is the miner in question today. So big thank you to them. But now, let's have a look at the current landscape of Siacoin miners. So, since they were nice enough to send me one of these SC Box 2s, let's have a look at CoinMiningCentral's website to see what Siacoin miners are currently available to us and the price landscape for them. And by the way, they've also been nice enough to give you guys a discount code for $120 off any purchase on their site. You can find that discount code in the video description next to an affiliate link to their website. That means that if you do decide to get one of these miners we're about to look at and you do so through that link, you help support the channel with a small commission at no extra cost to you. So big thanks to you if you do that. It really does make a big difference right now. All right, so if we come to their webpage here, we can hover over the product section and then hit Siacoin to see all of the available Siacoin miners. And there's four of them that I want to compare in this video: the SC Box 2, the HS Lite, the HS6, and the SC6 SE. So I've got them all in a spreadsheet here with the price after using the discount code, hash rate, power consumption, what they cost to run on my power cost of 13 cents per kilowatt hour, the current daily yield in Siacoin, daily revenue in dollars, and finally the daily profit in dollars after paying for power. And what I want us to look at here first, which is why I'm saying this is the best Siacoin miner, is the mining efficiency, the watts used per terahash of hash rate. Basically, you want this to be as low as possible, meaning the miner uses as little power as possible per terahash. I've made the sheet here, so the darker the green the cell is, the better. And as you can see, the SC Box 2 in low power mode is the absolute best here, using only 179 watts per terahash. What that means is that if profitability were to decrease, whether because the network hash rate increases, the coin price drops, or your power price goes up, the SC Box 2 will be the one that stays profitable the longest, since you are paying less in power per terahash of hash rate. So you can pause the video here if you want to have a closer look at the spreadsheet. I'll also leave a link to it in the description if you want to make a copy and insert your own power price. But with that out of the way, let's move on to look at the $500 miner comparison sheets here as well. So I've got all four of the new second generation Goldshell box miners here: the Siacoin one that we have already been talking about, the Mini Doge 2, the CK Box 2, and the KD Box 2. Now, to be fair, the Mini Doge is actually above $500, but it felt silly to not include that one. I've also included the only two other miners I could find in this price range that were also profitable: the iPollo Mini Grin miner and the iPollo V1 Mini SE. Now, bear in mind, this is not the plus version, so this is just the 200 megahash one. The 400 megahash one is usually around $1,000. So I got all the numbers here that you might be interested in. So again, you can either pause the video or make a copy of the sheet linked in the video description. But let's just have a look at what you all came here for, which is the profitability. So currently, the SC Box 2 is the only of the Goldshell ones that is actually profitable at my electric rate of 13 cents per kilowatt hour, making about 23 cents a day right now after power. And also, as we can see, that is the highest profit of all of them, compared to the G1 Mini that makes 13 cents off the power and the V1 Mini SE that makes 18 cents off the power. Now, real quick, I also want to show you how you can actually get this SC Box 2 for under $500, because if you look at CoinMiningCentral's website, you might say that, hey, That's not $500. But here's the thing. They give you the option to order it without a power supply. And this miner actually just uses two regular 6-pin connectors for power. So if you already have a server PSU lining around, perhaps from a GPU rig that is currently turned off anyway, then you're already good to go. No need to pay extra for the PSU. And Goldshell, who makes this miner, actually even claims that you can run it off a regular ATX power supply with just a jumper cap. However, I personally would probably not recommend doing that, since it does pull up to 400 watts of power, which is kind of a lot for a regular PSU to handle over just two 6-pin cables. But so, without the PSU, we are now down to $600. And as I mentioned earlier, there is a discount code for you in the video description that gives you $120 off any purchase. So, if you go to checkout, we can see that the price of the miner is actually £500. And with the discount code that takes off £100, the final price comes down to £400, which is just about $490 and should include shipping as well. So, let's finish this video with a quick rundown of how to mine Siacoin. So to mine Siacoin, you need three things: a miner like this Goldshell SC Box 2, a Siacoin wallet, and a mining pool. You of course also need power and an internet connection. After plugging in and powering on your miner, you need to find the internal IP number for your miner to open up the settings dashboard. If you have a Goldshell miner like this one, you can simply go to find.goldshell.com in your web browser and click on your miner in the list. If you don't have a Goldshell, you can just download a network scanning app to find the IP of your miner. There are loads of good ones. I use an app on my iPhone called Fing for this. You then need to open your miner's dashboard in the browser by going to that IP. They'll look a bit different depending on which miner you have, but they all basically do the same thing. First, you need to look up Siacoin on miningpoolstats.stream to find a pool. I'm going with siamining.com. Then just copy the pool address, including the port number of the server that is closest to you, and paste that into the pool address field in your miner dashboard. Then finally, you need to enter your Siacoin wallet address. I recommend using the official Sia UI wallet that you can download on their website at sia.tech/get-started. Paste that wallet address in like this, followed by a period, and then whatever you want the name of your miner to be. Save the settings, and that's it. You can now track your mining progress on the pool website by looking up your wallet address, and here you can also set your minimum payout threshold in the settings. All right, hopefully that covered everything. So please let me know your thoughts on Siacoin in the comments, and give the video one of these if you enjoyed it.